Welcome everyone. In this lecture, we will globally set the header and footer of our website. But before we do that, I want you to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you can get notified. And it will help me post new videos and provide good contents to you also. And it will keep me motivated as well so that I can give my 100% in delivering the lecture. So without further ado, let's get started. In the last lecture, we saw how to make the index.php page, the single.php page file, and the page.php file. In this lecture, we will set our header and footer globally. So this was our home page, right? And it is powered by the index.php file. But you have seen in the most of the website, there is a header section at the very top and a footer section at the very bottom. So how we include them? Let's see that. So let's jump back to the editor. And here, this is our index.php file. Now let's write at the very top some dummy text in h1 HTML tags. This is the header area. And at the very bottom, after the closing PHP tag, let's write something in paragraph HTML tag. This is the footer area. Save this. Now if I refresh, here this is the header area and this is the footer area. But now if I go to some other pages, like if I click any of this post right now, let's click this one. We can see this details page of the post, but we don't see our header and we don't even see our footer. Why? Because this home page is powered by the index.php file, and we wrote our header and footer in that index.php file only. So that means that we don't have our header and footer in all the other pages. So to include the header and footer in all the pages, we need to do it manually. We need to put the header and footer manually in every pages. Suppose there are 10 pages, 10 files, then we need to do that in every file and pages. And that would be a very hectic problem. We don't do things like that in the program world. Why? Because suppose in future you want to change something in the header section, and suppose it's a very minute change, but in order to do that, you need to change that minute detail in every page, and that will take a lot of time. So what we do, we put header and footer in some specific file, and we fetch that information from there in every files we want. How we can do that? Let's see that. Jump back to the editor, and in our fictional university directory, let's create a new file and name this header.php. Put a h1 tag here and write this greetings from the header file. Save this. Now go to your index page, index.php file, and remove this. Okay, and now here open PHP and write a PHP function get header. So we are calling this function. There is an inbuilt function get header, and we are calling this function. And this, what this function will do, it will fetch all the information from the header.php file. Now let's go to the browser and hit refresh. So as you can see, we got the information from the header.php file. Now let's do that with the footer part also. For that, let's create another new file here and let's name this footer.php. greeting. Greetings from the footer file. Save this. Now go to index.php file. Remove this. And here, drop into PHP again and write get footer. But as you can see here, we are starting PHP and ending PHP here, and we are once again starting PHP. So what we can do, we can remove this the starting PHP and the closing PHP here. Right now also, this section is in PHP and this section is also in PHP. Same thing we can do with the footer also. Cut this from here. Cut it from here and paste it in here inside the PHP only. And let's remove this. Now save this. Now go to your browser and hit refresh. Okay, so you can see greeting from the footer file. But if I go to any single post, we don't see our header and footer. So let's include them globally. Go to your editor. Now go to your header.php file. Now let's remove this. Now let's write in some boilerplate, the boilerplate of HTML. Doc type HTML. Now let's create the HTML sandwich. Inside that, let's create the head sandwich. And the body sandwich. Okay, so in if you have done HTML before, then you might know that we include our CSS and JavaScript, CSS mainly CSS, in the head section, and we include our JavaScript just below the ending of the body section, right? So let's see how we can include the CSS files in WordPress. For that, let's use a WordPress function, put in PHP in here and write the WordPress function WP underscore head. And let's write something here in the body part in h1 tag. This is the header. Okay, so what this function will do, this will include all the CSS file. It will, WordPress will understand on its own, and it will include all the CSS files to the head section of your website. Suppose in future you install any plugins and that plugin has some CSS properties. So what WordPress will do, WordPress will include the files of that plugin in the head section of your site. And how it will do that? It will do that with the help of this function, WP head. Now let's save this and save this header.php file. Now go to your browser and hit refresh. Okay, so here you can see this is the header. But now also, if we navigate to any individual post, we won't see the header and footer. So let's do that now. As you know that this individual blog section is powered by the single.php file. So let's include our header and footer there. Go to your editor, then go to single.php file, and at the very beginning, after the opening of the PHP tags, let's include the function get header. Similarly, right above the closing PHP tag, let's include the function getFooter. Now don't forget about the individual pages. Go to your WordPress dashboard, then navigate to pages. And in the last lecture, we have created our dummy page, my first page. Let's view this page. Here you can see there is no header or footer also. So we need to include the header and footer in the page.php file also, because this page powers the individual pages. So here, let's remove this. Okay, we don't need this. And here, let's write the function getHeader. And right here, let's write the function getFooter. Let's remove this the end also, we don't want it. Save this. Come here, now hit refresh. Now we can see the header and the footer in this single page file also, in the individual page. Now if I refresh here, we can see the header and the footer in the individual post also, and we can even see it in the home page of our website. But now the thing which is left is to include the head black bar that we have at the top of our website. Like if you go to the dashboard, you can see this top bar, the black bar we have. We need this in our front end also here. So how we can include that? Let's see. Okay, so we will include that, and we will see how we can include the styling of our website as well. We have our style.css file, but as we already saw that we can't directly put styles in here. Like if we try to style some elements, we won't be able to do that. Like if I change the background color, and if I hit refresh, nothing happens. Because that is not how WordPress include its styles. For including the styles and the JavaScripts in our site, we need to create another file, and the name of the file is functions.php. Let's create that file, functions.php. And let me tell you that this file is different than any other files we have, because all the files like the index.php, page.php, single.php, header.php and whatsoever, all these files are like the template files. It represents the view of our website, what we can see in the HTML mode. But the functions.php file is a private file that everybody, the front end user, the end users don't see this file, because this, the things we put here actually tells WordPress what to do and when to do. It talks with WordPress, it talks to WordPress so that it can perform certain actions. So what we need to do right now, we need to include our styling of our website. So how we can do that? Let's see. First, let's drop down in PHP and let's write a function. Okay, and the name of the function is addAction. Okay, so as you can see here, this is a function call. We are calling this function, and the function is addAction. Now it accepts two parameters, parameter A, comma parameter B. These are not the actual parameters we are passing. These are the placeholder. You can say this A and B are the placeholders right now. Now I will explain what actually goes in here. Here we pass a hook. In WordPress terms, we call it hook. And the name of the hook is WP on queue. Scripts. And in the second, okay, let me tell you first what this hook does. This hook tells WordPress when to perform a certain action. Okay, and to make you understand in a better manner, let's first pass the second parameter also. In the second parameter, we pass another function. We call another function from the second argument. Suppose we will just now create the function which we are going to pass here. We will write the name of the function. Here we will write the function which we want to call, and that function we will create just now. We haven't declared that function yet, but we will do it just now. First, let's call that function without declaring the function. That might sound a bit crazy, but just understand it, guys, and just focus on what I do and how I am doing all these things. So suppose we want our stylings, we want the styles and the JavaScripts of our website to be included. So let's suppose we name our function as University Resources. This will be the name of our function, University Resources. Okay, now this is the name of the function which we want to call. So we need to declare this function, right? We need to create this function. So let's create this function first. Function University Resources. Okay, so we have created the function, and now let's put some code in between inside this function. So here goes another WordPress function like WP on queue not scripts. Now what is our main thing we want to do here right now? We want to include the stylings, right? So the function name will be WP on queue style. Okay, semicolon. Inside this, we also pass two arguments. The first argument is a nickname for our style.css file. Any nickname, you can make up this name, it doesn't matter, it's up to you, but something which you can relate. So let's name this main style. Okay, now comma. Now the second argument. In the second argument, we provide the path of the style.css file. We will provide the path of the styling files we have. But right now, in the current scenario, we only have one style.css file. We only have one .css file, right? And that is the style.css file. So this style.css file is the main file, main styling file of WordPress. So in this case, we don't have to actually specify the path. WordPress has another function which it will directly include the style.css file, because that's the sole file of the WordPress theme. And the name of the function to include the style.css file is get stylesheet URI. So we have our function with the name of the University Resources, and inside that we want to include this style. Okay, this style.css file. How we do that? For that we need another WordPress function, and that is WP on queue style. In that we pass two arguments. One argument is a nickname for the style.css file, and the second argument is the path of the style.css file. Now we need to call this function. This function won't work until and unless we run this or we call this function, as we have seen in our previous lectures. So how we call this function? We don't directly call this function. We pass it here in this second argument of this function. In the second argument, we pass this, we call this function by passing its name. But you might be thinking, in the previous videos when we were calling a function, we used to provide this brackets, right? The first brackets. But here we are not. Why? Because we are not directly calling this file. We are telling WordPress that, hey, I have a function with this name and I want to execute the function. I want you to run the function, but I am not telling you when to run it. I am leaving that to you. Whenever you feel like this is the most suitable time, you run this function. And how WordPress will run this function, how WordPress will understand that what is the suitable time and it should run this function? By this statement. WP onQueue scripts. This for the first arguments help WordPress understand when to run this function, and these two are the arguments of this function. So in a whole, we write a function and we execute them like this. If you want to execute a JavaScript file, then nothing will change. You just need to copy this line and paste it in here, and you need to change this style to script, not scripts, not plural, just script. But don't worry with that, because in the later lectures I will show you how we can include our JavaScripts to our website. So if I save it right now, just save this, and I go to the browser and hit refresh. So see, as you can see, we got our styling. We have successfully included our stylings of the website. But and if you go to any single post, if you want, like here, we can see the styling in every page, because it is in the header section. We included it in the header section here. If you go to your header.php, see, we have this function WP head. It automatically understands we have a certain file in the functions.php, a styling file, and we need to include that file in the head section. Okay, so now let's change a certain things, that this is the header part, and let's copy the closing HTML and closing body tag. Just cut it from here. Okay, so this is the head. Our body starts from here, then we have our heading, and then we have our genuine content, like this, whatever we have. From here we are getting the header from the header.php file, then we have our genuine content, and then we are getting the footer from the footer.php file. Where is it? Here. So what I will do, I will paste it in here, the closing body tag and the closing HTML tag. And just before the closing body tag, we will write another WordPress function, WP footer. Why? Because in the header, as you have seen, that we have written the WP head function, so that WordPress understands if there are certain CSS files or CSS plugins that will be included in the head section. But if you are a web developer and you are working in HTML or any other languages like PHP, you already should know that we include the CSS files in the head section, but we do include the JavaScript files in the footer section. Okay, so we need to pass another WordPress function, so that the whatever JavaScript files we have or JavaScript plugins we have, that should be included in the footer section. So that's why we have this function, so that it can fetch all those function and all those plugins functions in the footer section. Now if I save this and I hit refresh, okay, so now you can see that we got our black bar at the top also. That means our header and footer is both successfully loaded. So let's change this color. It is very harsh to the eyes. Let's remove the red color. Okay, refresh. Pretty good, right? We have our black bar at the top. We are loading our header, which is globally loaded in every page and posts we have, and we are getting our footer also. And we have even seen how to actually load the styling files in our WordPress website. So in the next lecture, we will have more fun and we will keep rolling. So if you're liking my lectures, please do like my videos, share and subscribe, and please guys, don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you get notified every time, and it will give me a boost to teach you even more good contents, and we will learn a lot of new things. Till then, bye, have a great day.